Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 22, Poverty. And our topic is Urban Poverty in India. The acceleration of structural changes and poverty analysis is that the level of urban is more closely linked with overall indicators of economic development than with specific indicators related to industrialization or urbanization. Indeed, the close correlation with the level of rural poverty indicates that the two cannot be viewed separately. Given relatively high labor mobility, this is not surprising. Increasing level of urban welfare naturally pulls in job aspirants from rural areas. If conditions are much worse, conversely, rural prosperity has its reflection in relative urban prosperity through generation of urban activities resulting from demand stimulation. It is also of some significance that the variance in rural poverty is much higher than in urban poverty. Urban activities are essentially footloose. Urban labor markets are probably more national in character than the rural labor markets. Moreover, rural productivity is more clearly rooted in and immovable assets, land, and hence less prone to greater variance between states. The rate of change in the employment structure has lagged far behind that of output and value added. Manufacturing activities have indeed grown apace, but not perhaps fast enough. There is a clear evidence of an accelerating change in the employment structure. Also, contrary to the popular impression, manufacturing employment and not the tertiary sector has been the fastest growing sector. There seems to have been a greater tendency of industrial dispersal up to the mid-1970s. The subsequent. From the evidence, it is difficult to argue that the industrial dispersion had any significant effect on urban poverty removal, though the correlation of urban poverty and manufacture activities are generally in the right direction. The key regional pattern that emerges in really on east-west divide. The states with persistently high poverty level, both rural and urban, are Bihar, MP, Orissa, UP, and Tamil Nadu. The advanced states of West Bengal and Maharashtra also exhibit high level of rural poverty. Thus, the three traditionally advanced industrial states, West Bengal, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, all exhibits high levels of rural poverty. As a result, their urban poverty levels are also not low, as might have been expected. What is of great interest is that Haryana and Punjab are found to be the most successful in all spheres, and this have been achieved without large-scale industrial investment. Yet the growth in manufacturing employment is among the highest in these states, including employment in household industries, which is generally declining elsewhere. The level of urban poverty is lowest in these states as well. Non-agricultural employment in both rural and urban areas. Along with all these changes, urbanization also accelerated significantly in these states. also the key to removal of urban poverty is agricultural growth. It is difficult to sustain a high growth rate in manufacturing activity and urban employment without the accompanying improvements in the agricultural productivity. Indeed, the magnitude of non-agricultural employment growth that is needed for poverty removal can only occur if there is adequate growth in agricultural productivity. The evidence from the older industrialized states is clear. Poverty removal in these states is stymized by languishing hinterlands, despite high levels of industrialization and urbanization. The effect of accelerated agricultural growth would be most felt in the generation of non-agricultural activities, both in rural as well as in the small and medium towns, whose primary function is the service of their hinterland. Big cities are then indirectly affected through operation of the labor market and through enhanced demand for their products and services from the small and medium towns. The decay of the eastern region emerges as the most significant problem. The strategy of locating heavy industries in the eastern and central states has had little beneficial impact in terms of poverty removal. Vast areas in Bihar, MP, Odisha, UP, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka have very low productivity agricultural regions. Their levels of urbanization and industrialization are among the lowest in the world, along with some of the highest indices of poverty. Industrial dispersion, in the absence of the significant direct attack on the agricultural productivity, will do little to reduce urban or rural poverty in these areas. All the evidence suggests that the slow decrease in poverty in India has been caused by slow overall structural change. The fact that employment structure has changed much more slowly than that of value added suggests that the investment strategy has been wrong. Being aimed at the dispersal of heavy and large industry rather than agriculture and light industries. A self-sustaining planned poverty removal in urban and rural areas can only be reached if the investment strategy is oriented towards a much more accelerated generation of non-agricultural employment. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with a self-learning podcast.